where does the sine function come from? We've all seen this function graphed before, but where does it come from? So I've plotted this graph in terms of degrees for demonstration purposes. To understand where the sine function comes from, we need to take a look at a circle. I've plotted a circle here with a radius of 12 inches. And inside of the circle, I've inscribed triangles. Each of the triangles has a 90 degree angle at its foot. And I've plotted them at different degrees. So this first one has an angle of 30 degrees relative to the x-axis. This one here. And then this one here has an angle of 45 degrees relative to the x-axis. And then this one here has an angle of 60 degrees relative to the x-axis. So, where the sine function comes from, the sine function comes from plotting the height of each of these triangles divided by the radius, that is the hypotenuse of each triangle. The hypotenuse of each triangle is the radius of the circle, right? Because this is 12, this is 12, this is 12, so the hypotenuse is always the same for each of them. And the sine function comes from dividing the height of each triangle divided by that hypotenuse. So, let's do the first one. For 30 degrees, we will look at this triangle right here. Let's measure the height here. And the height is 6 inches. So 6 divided by 12 is 0.5. So we come over here, we look at our graph, and we come out to 30 degrees. And we see that 0.5 is on the graph. Lo and behold. So we contend that the sine of theta is simply equal to the ratio of the height of each respective triangle divided by the hypotenuse of each respective triangle, which is the radius. So this is simply equal to y over r. So then let's do it for the next one. So this one has an angle of 45 degrees relative to the x-axis, and we measure the height of it, and the height of it is 8.48 inches. So 8.48 divided by 12 is equal to 0.707. So we come over here at 45 degrees, and we come up to the graph, and lo and behold, it's at an elevation of 0.707. It has a y value of 0.707. And then we come up, we take a look at the triangle corresponding to 60 degrees. We measure the height of it, and we get a height of 10.39 inches. 10.39 inches divided by 12 is equal to 0.866. So we come out to 60 degrees, we come up to the graph, and lo and behold, 0.866 is right there. And then of course we see the number 1, because at 90 degrees, it's just the radius divided by the radius. Because at 90 degrees, the height of this triangle is the height of the radius, because we see that the width of this triangle is getting shorter and shorter and shorter until right here when the width of the triangle is equal to 0. And we progress around the circle plotting this ratio for all of these different triangles. The one catch is that when we get to 180 degrees, we go negative, because all of these triangles were above the x-axis, so these all had positive y values, positive heights that is. But all of these have negative heights because they're below the x-axis. So we see that from 0 to 180, we have positive values, and we just plot all the way around the circle. But then when we get to 180, we go negative, and we have negative values. That is, the ratios are negative. So let's just take a look at one of those. Take a look at this triangle right here. This triangle has an angle of 210 degrees. So it's 180 plus 30, which is 210. And so we measure the height of that one. And the height is 6, but it's below the x-axis, so it's negative 6. Negative 6 divided by 12 is negative 0.5. So lo and behold, we come out to 210 degrees. We come down to the graph, and lo and behold, look, it's right there at negative 0.5. Negative 0.5. And we continue plotting around the circle to get the rest of these values. That's it. That is where the sine function comes from. In the next tutorial, we are going to discuss what the utility of the sine function is, and how can we use this thing? How can we exploit this thing to our advantage? Okay, see you next time.